Well, in less than an hour, the first team, football team that is, will arrive at Armstrong International Airport ahead of the All-State Sugar Bowl. WDAC News reporter Gina Swanson is live at 5 at the airport with that story. Gina, lots of people excited.
Absolutely, Rachel. Things are certainly picking up out here at the airport. You can see all the buses behind me at the ready to whisk away the Cincinnati Bearcats and their organization off to hotels downtown. But no matter what happens in the Sugar Bowl, this is always a win for the city of New Orleans. We all know that bowl games are economic engines for the host city. And with us now to tell us more is the chief operating officer of the Sugar Bowl. Now, we know that this event normally brings in $150+ million. Can we expect to see that same type of economic impact this year?
Well, chances are it won't be quite that strong this year. We've had a little bit slower ticket sales with the economy and one of the schools having a little difficulty getting over some early expectations that they had for their season. But overall, we still think it's going to be a great event. If you'd have told us going in that we would have the number 3 and number 5 ranked teams in the country, given that we had the last selection in the BCS selection process, we would have run for the hills with that. So we're happy about the matchup and think that we'll do well.
Have you guys been in contact with hotels and restaurants just to touch base about what their numbers are looking like?
We have. To a degree, we understand that it's not where they've grown accustomed to when we've had the sellout games, but we won't be far short of a sellout, and we think that it's, again, it's going to be a good game and a good impetus for the economy here.
And the last question, the team's arriving. Tell us how we're going to greet them in a good New Orleans fashion. What's going to take place out here?
Well, several of our committee members will be here to welcome them. We've got a big New Orleans jazz band ready as they come off the plane. Then we'll be off and running with all sorts of parties and events throughout the week, practices, the All-State Fan Fest on the 30th and the 31st. So we've got a lot of great things lined up this week.
Thank you very much. We certainly appreciate your time, and we know lots of people are looking forward to this event that kicks off a busy first quarter of events here in the city, and certainly a lot of businesses are looking forward to it as well. That's the story for now. We're on your side. I'm Gina Swanson for WDSU News.
Thanks so much, Gina. Kickoff is at 7:30 next Friday. Fletcher Mackel will have more on the build-up to the big game coming up a little later on in sports.